English, Department of Science and Humanities, VFTR, Vijnan University, Badlamudi, Andhra Pradesh. He is a multilingual scholar, hailing from India. His study on New Criticism in the Light of Poetics, the popular literature on Western criticism and Indian aesthetics. He presented research papers on English language teaching, comparative literature in 4 international conferences. He has 84 research articles published in Scopus of Science and UGC Careless Journal. 10 scholars were awarded PhD and 2 MPhils were also awarded under his guardianship. He was considered thrice as the best teacher by Dr. Y.S. Rajasekhar Reddy. He is a regular columnist in Telugu and English dailies, covering various social, cultural, and literary writings. Most of his projects were also approved by government bodies like ICSSR, New Delhi, MHD, and others. His areas of interest include English teaching, literature, and translations. I welcome, sir. We are all eagerly waiting for you for to hear your words, sir. You welcome, you, sir.
Good morning. Thank you, everyone, for joining this national seminar. It's my proud privilege and great honor to have our minister, Dr. Mohanacharyulu, a great friend of mine and guide, multifaceted personality, not only in English, Sanskrit and Telugu, a scholar of repute, and a producer of so many doctorates by his guidance. Truly a great scholar. I always appreciate him for his great work, not only in English, but also in Telugu also. He's a teacher of eminence. He taught in Ambedkar Open University, LU, and now he works in Vijnan University. It is really a privilege again to say the few words about him. A great humanitarian. He always loves students, loves to teach them in very possible, simple English. I have taken that cue from him. I have already taken a leaf out of his book that very humble, very committed teacher. Naturally, if you have such eminence, scholarly person, we won't fight simplicity. There is an adage that simplicity is the symbol of a scholar. So for me, he is very synonymous with that adage. I have to say a lot, but for sake of time, I welcome him and thank him for giving us time, taking time off to visit our college in the morning, talk with our students, and students felt very happy to listen to him. Thank you, sir. We used to call him Jimocha because G. Mohanacharyulu. Our relationship started in the way back 1998, still going on very strong. So hope until I be the last, I would like to continue his association. So thank you, sir, once again for accepting an invitation and giving his a lecture. Thank you, Mohanacharyulu sir. Thank you, ma'am, for giving the opportunity. Anji, ma'am, please kindly forward. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much, sir. Now I request today's resource person, Dr. J. Mohanacharyulu garu, to give his lecture. You use your laptop. Is it there on the desktop? But it takes me for 5 minutes to open your PPT. Okay. If it is there on your desktop, you... Meanwhile, I set it this. Just wait a minute, everyone, please. It's not opening here, so that's the problem. So search. Settings are different. No, you have to connect our Wi-Fi, sir. I'll tell the password.
Ma'am, voice avadam ledhu, madam.
Okay. Yes. Okay. I think I'm seeing that, right?
No, it is okay. Here it is open.
Okay.
Here it is open.
Okay. Okay. No need to minimize. Okay, please.
Slideshow.
So, that's it.
We can't see the audience, no?
Yes, we can't see. Yes, that is the problem.
Okay, now stop sharing that problem. Do the most.
Okay.
Minimize this, minimize that sometimes.
Yeah.
If you want to see the
icons,
you have to minimize.
Okay, right. Yes. A very good afternoon to everyone. Thank you for joining here and sharing our ideas and exchanging our views. I appreciate the prestigious organization SRNBGNR.
Also,
the college for taking an initiation for arranging this webinar and also making an interesting topic related with conceptualizing teaching and research. My dear friends, as we know, as a teaching community, we are sailing in two boats. The first one is teaching, the next one is the research. Because the teaching community itself only witnesses different generations. There are a few faculty members who have joined in this webinar, might have credited with 2 to 3 decades of experience. But my dear friends, students 30 years back are completely different from the students of a contemporary period. There are various changes in teaching methodology. there are various changes in teaching approaches. Even within the classroom, teaching for arts different from teaching for science. Teaching for technology is different from teaching pharmacy. So, my dear friends, when we are handling various types of classes and generations and students, our approach is not an easy task. It is not a cakewalk. It is a kind of exercise where every teacher has to satisfy student in the classroom by the style of approach in dictating the contents of the curriculum to the minds of the students. There are various ways. So today, the topic which I wanted to discuss with you and share my ideas with you is conceptualizing teaching and research. As I told you, the methods of teaching changes generation to generation. As there are other students in the style of teaching written by Kushwant Singh, where I liked him very much. In Kushwant Singh's short stories, in one of the short stories, I would like to recollect it for a minute to conceptualize what the topic I wanted to go and explain here and share my ideas with you. A pretty daughter talking to her father, who is very serious in preparing her studies and forthcoming examinations. Surprisingly, the daughter is in UKG itself, not even for first standard. Even in the first class or even in the UKG level, she is very seriously preparing for forthcoming examinations. Then father came. Every father is quite happy when his daughter is preparing for examinations and paying attention to the studies. Then father asked, "Ma, what you are doing? Don't disturb father, I am preparing for exams." Then father is very happy. My dear friends, when the students say themselves that we are preparing for exams, generally every teacher is very happy. In the same way, father is also very happy. And the whole night, the daughter prepared well and went for exams. After completion of the exam, the daughter got only a few marks, not even 50%. Then father surprised with why you got less marks. The student said, "Father, the questions given in the examination are out of syllabus questions." Then father surprised, "Why out of syllabus questions, my dear? Show me the question paper." Then daughter showed the question paper. The first question is, identify the bird for 10 marks for LKG and UKG level. Then daughter said that there are only three birds, sparrow, duck, and some other one. Then daughter showed the textbook. "Show me the birds here in the textbook." Daughter said that there are only three birds in the textbook, so that the question should be from that three birds only. Why from other birds? Why they asked about peacock? It is not there in the textbook. The second question, identify the colors. There are three colors in the textbook. This daughter prepared only those three colors, but the fourth color is given in the examination. Immediately daughter demanded father, no, you come and ask my principal why all the questions are out of syllabus questions. So my dear friend, Kushwant Singh concluded this story by saying that the designers of curriculum keep in their mind only a few things. It is the responsibility of the teacher to elaborate the idea of the designers of the curriculum and impart quality education, so that every curriculum should have certain scope for further reading. So that only three birds are not birds in this world. There are n number of birds, but it is not possible to study about them. But there are a few more than three in the textbook. There are not only two or three colors in the, from the textbook. There are n number of colors, but the student failed to identify them. It is the responsibility of the teacher explaining that the sums are colors or birds given in the textbook are only the birds and the colors in this world. World is so wide, so that knowledge is also so wide. This is what Pushpant Singh wanted to say. Same can be applicable here for teaching and research. How it is, most of the students while taking classes in the classroom, they ask us, when you start teaching, sir, is this lesson important for exams? Means their focus is only on the examination. If you say there is a 10 mark question from this lesson, definitely they pay full attention on this. If you say there is only 1 mark question from this lesson, they pay less attention, and they pay even their deaf ear also, because on the intensity of the marks, on the gravity of the scoring of the marks, the students will try to give top priority for that. But as the teacher, it is our responsibility, whether it is 1 mark question or 10 mark question, we should go through it and give important contents of that. But this examination and in this curriculum, maybe this consists of only 1 question, but in the forthcoming examinations or in future, it may turn the entire career. Because according to the designers of the curriculum, according to the teaching and evaluation pattern, they might have allotted 1 or 2 marks for that. It doesn't mean that it has low gravity or low intensity and less important. But if they have given 10 marks for that, it is a huge importance, and it is only the thing that we should go through it. But another most important thing I would like to share with you, marks are not the criteria, but the quality and the content of the curriculum, how better we transferred to the student's mind and injected to them, is very important. In this concept, under this slide, I would like to share a few ideas with you. As I told you, teaching and research, these two are not two separate things. They are interdependent and they are complementary to each other. Because every teacher in the classroom is a scientist and making some experiments with that. This academic year, we may take the same class, and in the next academic year, the same lesson can be taught in a different way. What may be the reason for this? For this purpose, there is a critic called William Emerson. He made an investigation on this. He explained a lesson related to road not taken by Young Falls, by Robert Falls. When the poem is explained in a systematic way by William Emerson, there are 10 students in the classroom. They observed it and they understood it. And the teacher, William Emerson, asked the student to write about the poem that they understood. 10 students have written 10 types these 10 types of explanations are given for the same poem explained by the 10 teacher. Here we can understand that a teacher can explain a lesson in the classroom, 60 students will understand in 60 ways. So we should pay attention how the intensity of the students and the measurements of the students are taken for the explanation here. That is what a teacher has to do. Not simply dictating the lesson and the content of the lesson in the classroom is not enough. It is the duty of the teacher to observe the student and how better they can impart quality education on the content given in the curriculum in the next class. So in this context, I would like to share a few ideas to you. When we are sharing certain things to the students, particularly whatever the subject it may be, whether it is botany, zoology, physics, or whether it is economics or public administration or languages or whatever it may be. As it is a global education, as it is the education taking top priority for English, remember that the students, some of them are non-native speakers of English. So the medium of instruction at higher level after graduation or from graduation or below graduation, the medium of instruction is English. So most of the teachers, they try to explain the contents in English. They should try for that. For this purpose, while explaining certain things or concepts in our classroom, learners' knowledge on native language plays a dominant role in that. If the learner is from a local vernacular, that is a regional language, but the medium of instruction is in a non-vernacular. It is like English. So that there is a gap between the teacher and the learner. Learner wanted to understand the concept in their native language, and the speaker explains in a non-native language. So that there is a clash between the teacher and the taught. How this clash is to be built? So that, my dear friends, we should encourage the learners try to understand the concept which the teacher is going to explain in English. When we teach English as a medium of instruction, most of the students are from mother tongue. It is first language. Most of the research scholars in English, they say that the first language and the second language, L1 and L2, differences. L2, L1 is the language one which we acquired from our mother. Mother may be a Malayali or a Tamil or a Kannada. We can learn the language. L2 is the second language where our second language is learned. So, which is not our mother tongue, the question comes over here. Which is not our mother tongue? Which is not our mother tongue? Wherever a non-native speaker, see, for example, for Telugu speakers, Hindi is a non-native language. So Hindi is treated as a L2, it is a second language. Which is not my mother tongue is a second language. In teaching an English as a second language, English is the second language. When we adopt English, so that English is treated as a second language. So in which medium of instruction we are taking classes in the classroom? It is only in English. So that TESL, teaching English as a second language. When we are teaching English as a second language, then what is the role of the teacher while handling this one? Students are from L1 and medium of instruction is from L2. So here the role of the teacher starts as a teacher and as a researcher. When you are teaching the student certain concepts related to the topics of botany, zoology, physics, chemistry, or any branch of learning, we should pay attention how better we prepared, adequately trained to give the concepts in the topic which we are going to discuss here. It is the role of the teacher to have an enormous knowledge on the concept which we are going to tell. So that, my dear friends, once we prepare for one concept in 2015, if we apply the same concept in 2021 is not possible. Because the style of handling the classrooms in 2015 is different from 2021. So that there is an updated knowledge of the curriculum development in the mind of the teacher. So that teacher should always be an updated one, not an outdated one. For example, I completed my BED in 2006. I learned a few concepts of teaching in 2006. If I apply the same concepts in 2021, it will be an utterly failure classroom. For example, I thought task-based language teaching is the best theory for the teacher, students in the classroom. Or, I feel grammar translation method is the best method for the students of non-native speakers. So most of the students are Telugu medium background, so that I can follow my class as a grammar translation method. I speak 75% in English and 25% in Telugu as my students are native speakers. If we do in such a way, our classroom is a grammar translation classroom. Then what happens here in the 20th century, in 21st century, most of the students are right from the beginning in English medium only. In our students, the classroom is a mixed classroom. It is not completely English medium students classroom. It is not completely Telugu students classroom, or it is not completely only Telugu students classroom. Now, even in our SRNBGNR college, there are students from non-Telugu speakers, non-Telugu language students are there. So that while we are explaining things in the classroom, we should pay attention on two important things. If we wanted to conceptualize the teaching and research, how to conceptualize this? The students are from native background and the teacher is going to speak in a non-native language. So there is a clash. Now, here the role of the teacher as a teacher and the researcher. We pay attention on the content, we pay attention on the skill. These two are very important. While explaining the content in the classroom, what is the better idea to make the concept very easy to be grasped by the student in the classroom? We follow that method. Whether it is a direct method, whether it is a grammar translation method, whether it is a audio lingual method, or whatever method it is, that depends on the skill of the teacher. Content is an idea, and the skill is ability to perform the content properly in the classroom. How you explained the idea, for example, if it is a physics class, F is equal to MA is a theory. This idea the teacher wanted to explain. The teacher wanted to explain the same idea to the student in the classroom. Then he follows the method of explaining the idea F is equal to MA. How better he can perform in the classroom by taking different examples which are from the real-time experiences of the teacher. So that better explanation of F is equal to MA is dependent on the skill of the teacher. Right? Now the teacher has to adopt the method of his own skill in performing the content in the classroom. Right? Now the role. The teacher wanted to explain F is equal to MA. The same if it is MPC class, Maths, Physics and Chemistry, his style of skill used to perform in the class is different from Biology, Physics and Chemistry classroom. The same style and same performance will not be possible in MPC and BIPC class. Because the students who opted for BIPC, because of mathematical problems, they opted for BIPC. So that keeping this in the mind, what is the easy method of making the concept very easy to the students? A teacher has to own skill for performing this. So by creating this, when you have adopted one idea to perform the skill excellently, then you are proposing a theory in your class saying that my students of BSc MPC in SRNBGNR college, they are very excellent in understanding F is equal to MA principle through grammar translation method. This is the theory that you have proposed in your research. When you proposed a theory making that the ability of the students to understand this particular principle or concept in the classroom of this area will not be applicable to the students of BSc MPC in Hyderabad. That is also different. So that we should keep in the mind the region, we should keep in the mind cognitive level of the student, we should also keep in the mind the better understanding of the concepts in the classroom by the skill of the teacher. So my dear friends, now tell me how role of a teacher in the classroom. You should make a concept of that. My students from Bonakal Government Junior College are very poor in English. How can you say this? Because their abilities of speaking English are very poor. Then what are the reasons for that? There is no atmosphere of speaking in Bonakal. So what is our duty as a teacher? To create an atmosphere of speaking English in that particular area. For that purpose, what will you do? You apply your knowledge on that. you apply your skill. How can we apply here? How better ability I can do well in the classroom by taking class completely in English, by making very simple words to my students, so that the idea of content and the theory that you have proposed and the knowledge of the teacher, these three are very important in discharging the skill, ability to perform, and then ability to express. So my dear friends, when we have done all these things here, so for example, when we have taken the ability to concept to transform it excellently, what information that we are going to provide to the students, it is very important. You can give a good example for that. Taking number of examples to the students in the classroom, bringing them into their experience, as the teacher's experience is different, so that he should bring different examples to the classroom by transforming the idea of information to the particular students of the class. When you understand it very well, so that my dear friends, the idea of the content, theory of the content, and also the knowledge of the teacher, and also the information about the content, all these things are very important for performing, for expression of ideas, for performing excellently well in the classroom, and transforming the information. See, here the teacher role ends here. Now, teacher as a researcher starts now. Then you have taken class for 60 students for explaining a physical theory. How many of them are able to understand it? It is very important. So that how many of them are able to understand the concept of a physical TMA in a non-native language? If they are 50% or 60% or 70%, you should collect the information by conducting different types of slip test, different types of unit test, different types of weekly test. Yes, I have conducted 2 weekly tests and 2 slip tests on particular content, saying that the students of this section secured more than 60% or 50% of knowledge on that. Not marks, only knowledge, right? Then you start interpreting. Data collection is over. You have collected the data for this year from this section of students, and then you are interpreting. I adapted the method of grammar translation method in the classroom for explanation of a concept like a physical TMA, or a concept like biological sciences, or a public administration theory. In order to explain this, I followed this method of teaching in the classroom. When I followed this method of teaching in the classroom, out of 100 members, 75 members are able to understand the concept very easily. How you came to know that 70% of students are able to understand it? For this purpose, I have conducted 2 tests for that. With the result of this 2 tests, explain and they interpret that the concept which I explained is excellent. So that I followed this method, right? When you followed this method, if you are in a view that I can follow this method next year and after that also, is a wrong notion. This method is only for this year. So that the teacher is always an updated one. It is not an easy task. Most of the teachers opted this teaching profession as a pastime. I don't like to hurt them because they are making some dangerous things to the next coming generation. Teaching is a profession, something holy, where we opted for that. Our blood and nerve should spend for the purpose of increasing the cognitive levels of the students by spending more time. So that when we have delivered the content like this as a teacher, as a researcher, then there is a content-based story. You can explain the contents in view of audio clippings, or video clippings, or internet access, or newspaper explanations. If you wanted to draw the experiences of the classroom, you can bring various types of video clippings in order to make your classroom as a lively one. In order to make the class very excellently, very energetic and dynamic, it is the duty of each and every teacher to work very hard on the concept which they are going to explain in the classroom. So that teaching and research is the soul of every teacher. Just you can make explanation of different newspapers. By that you can make our students with the contemporary situations prevailing in and around world. We can make the students very lively by taking examples of video clippings and audio clippings in order to improve good communication skills among all the students. You can bring certain live interesting stories, real-time experiences of the teachers, real-time experiences of the hard-working people who are elevated in the society. These are the main concepts of the teacher. Means a teacher is always a researcher. He is a social scientist. He is a political scientist. He is an economic scientist. Above all, he is a real scientist. How can we say this? Because teacher can only make a student as an all-round personality or a versatile genius by the style of his speech, by the style of his dictation in the classroom. Just merely dictating the contents of the syllabus given by the curriculum in the classroom is a very easy task. If we follow any VGS guide or Apollo guide and taking it and getting it by hearted and giving to the students in the classroom and asking them, mugging it up and then reproduce them in the classroom, tomorrow I will conduct a slip test. You write a physical MA concept tomorrow for this purpose. You read this book, that's all. Mere dictating the concept in the classroom is not enough. This is what Bloom's taxonomy says. You should make the student to the third level. Third level in the sense that not remembering or understanding. You should make the students towards the level of application. Yes, I have taught them the concept of swimming. How to swim? There is a theory for that. In swimming is the theory. I can take a class for 20 minutes for swimming. And I can explain the concept of swimming 20 minutes. And after that, tomorrow I will keep an examination, explain about swimming. Every student writes about swimming. Then they get 9 out of 10 marks in that. Does it mean that every student got swimming skill in his cognitive level?
No.
Never. So that we should make the students and take the students to the level of a third level. That is application.
Yes.
We acquired the knowledge of this physical DMA. Why don't you apply this to our surroundings? I will tell you one real life situation. A student who failed 10th class and with laborious hard work he joined in intermediate, but he discontinued it in order to take his life very, very strong. He joined in ITI, which is given an admission after 10th class. He went for electrical engineering. And after completion of his course, he had a thought, because he looked at his father, who is a farmer, working from miles together, going to his farmhouse and switching off the light for the purpose of electricity to make all his land wet. Unfortunately, the government gives electricity in those days in 2010 and 2008. It is night 10 o'clock to 11 o'clock to early morning 5 o'clock. From night 10 o'clock, the father has to go to his farm, which is 3 kilometers away, and he should switch on it and then turn back. And early morning 4 o'clock, he has to go away there and again switch off the motor and then come back. This the student looked at, who pursued only ITI after 10th class. Then when he observed, sitting in his house, handling the TV with a remote. Remote consisting of 3 or 4 meters of range, and he handled everything and he got an idea that why can't I make a remote handling for 3 to 4 kilometers of distance. Then immediately he approached a few people like an experts in our physics and other electronics department in SR and BGNR college, and then he sought their assistance and all other things. And making some changes in the remote, he prepared a remote of handling 200 to 300 kilometers of distance. Then it was a huge revolutionary thought. So my dear friends, we can't expect that a student who is sitting in the classroom ideally, we can't say that he is very lazy fellow. Maybe some spark in him that we should identify. This is called the teaching and research, identifying the students.
మంచి మాట్లాడు మంచి మాట్లాడు మంచి మాట్లాడు మంచి మాట్లాడు మంచి మాట్లాడు
is the remote control of handling for 2 to 3 kilometers away that helped most of the farmers to switch on switch off their motors. So in teaching, as a, it is a story, the content of the story is application of knowledge, not simply remembering or understanding or getting it by heart. Just it is a kind of a transferring idea and application of idea. So the ways of transferring ideas are different. I may take a class, but my friend will take a class. But the content is the same, the style of delivery in the classroom is different. So that every teacher should establish their own style of teaching in the classroom. How is it possible? It is possible only through the ways of interpretation. How can we interpret the same concept? I can interpret a concept with different examples which are within the reach of the student's experience. But some of the students, some of the teachers may explain by taking different examples from the critics, eminent philosophers and great scientists who are above in the experiences of the students. Then there is a gap between the student and the teacher's cognitive level. The style of expressions of every teacher is different. So that the mode of handling the class is also different. Basing on this, the content of the curriculum can be taken into the mind of the student by following a systematic method. So my dear friends, so far I have taken examples from the other branches of subjects. Yes. Now hereafter, as an English teacher, I would like to take a few examples from language skills that I would like to tell you. See, the basic language skills, we call it as LOT, lower order thinking. Means lower order thinking language skills are generally, they are listening, speaking, reading and writing. These skills are lower LOT. Why they are lower order of thinking? Because listening is a biological process, speaking a biological process, reading and writing are very natural. They are acquired from the mother. It is common to all, whether he is rich or poor, if there is a thundering sound, the sound is same to a rich and it is same to poor also. If there is a rain, the rain flashes on the beggar is same, the rain flashes on the official is also the same. So that these LSRW skills are very common. These are basic language skills for each and everyone. Then how can we mold them into HOT, higher order thinking? These LSRW skills, LOT, how can we elevate them to the level of higher order thinking? When you wanted to make these LSRW skills into higher order thinking, you can make advanced language skills. See, for example, in listening. In listening, you can introduce certain literary concepts in it, some literary skills in it, some literary examples in it. By that, their listening skill will be improved. So that the medium of understanding the lower order level is same to all. But the observation of an advanced language skill makes the student to think in higher order level. Second one is the study skill, where we have to introduce at the advanced language skills to giving students regular practices on LSRW. Because it is the duty of a teacher to find out which is within the reach of the student's experience, and then we can give some exercises by improving their study skills. The third one, their communication skills. Every teacher has to speak to the students over phone or in person regularly for a couple of minutes. It is not a Herculean task. It is very easy to be associated with the student because students are our stakeholders. We are getting everything, we are getting our bread and milk from the student's pocket, where the parents worked very hard and paid their fees. And moreover, in order to improve this lower order level and higher order level of thinking, what are the skills that we can introduce here? Those were the days where combined family system is there. So students has to spend time of 9 to 3 o'clock in the classroom, means only for 7 hours with the teacher and 17 hours with the parents. So that parents, when they are very busy with some other works, grandparent or grandmother used to take care of the children, and she used to take certain moral stories or something else, so that they acquired all these skills naturally. But now what happened? All the family system, it is completely changed. Now only micro family system. Father very busy, mother is very busy, teacher is also very busy, because there are 138 works for the teacher in the classroom. Not only for teaching, there are n number of works for them. So that father busy, mother busy, teacher busy. Then who has to teach the moral strength to the student? This every teacher has to think of that. So that in order to make this, what happened nowadays in the curriculum, they have introduced certain life skills. And a decade back they said it is a soft skill. What is a soft skill and what is a hard skill? There is no difference at all. Soft skills and life skills. Now the changing method is, in 21st century, personality skills. They have written n number of books on personality skills. There was a joke also. A person who has written a book, How to Become a Millionaire, has acquired a millionaire by writing that particular book only. In the same way, these personality skills, life skills, and also soft skills, all these things are contemporary issues where a teacher has to deal in the classroom. Teacher should be a father in the classroom, very strict and controlling the student. Teacher should be a mother in the classroom, giving utmost love and affection and looking at the moral strength of the student. Teacher should be a teacher in the classroom, delivering the content of the curriculum and looking at the levels of the student and making him and bringing him to the level of understanding. Like this, so that Indian concept says that teacher is mother, teacher is father, teacher is everything, and even the God is next to teacher. So my dear friends, when the content delivery in the classroom, impressions of the teacher and style of teacher in delivering the content in the classroom, all these things play an important role on the student. So that teacher has to keep in the mind as a researcher all these things. Above all, character of the teacher is also very important. How can we look at it, the character of the teacher? I will tell you 2 examples. One at school level, second one at post school level. In school level, the style of teaching is teacher centric teaching. At primary school level or upper high school level or whatever it may be, at middle school, the entire curriculum is designed keeping in the mind the teacher centric one. Teacher will give you exercises, teacher will give you all the concepts, teacher will ask you to read everything. This is at school level. At post school level, it is a student centric level. Student centric level in the sense that at intermediate or graduation or post graduation, the study skills are related with student centric, not teacher centric. Next one, at school level, content quality is very low and monitoring the classroom is very important. At primary school level and upper primary school level, it is the quality of the teacher to see the student should attend the class on time, and he must be very punctual, and he should submit all his assignment in time. All these things are at primary and secondary level. So that punctuation, punctuality, sincerity, all other things are to be monitored by teacher in the classroom at school level. And another one is, student is forced to do something else in the classroom, that is at school level. And moreover, most of the teaching in the classroom at school level is a playway method. These are the things where school level teaching is. In school level teaching, it is a teacher centric, the content of the teaching is very low and monitoring the classroom is important and the students are forced to do certain things and moreover the method approach in the classroom is a playway method. Then what happens in the post school level? Post school level is completely a student centric one. The content is very high and moreover the monitoring the classroom is autonomous and moreover students are very very independent in expressing their ideas and whatever the ideas that they express independently they should have self dependence. For this purpose Bloom's taxonomy level has introduced various things. I would like to tell you one important thing here. There are two types of curriculums according to Mahabharata. The two types of curriculum, one type of curriculum is Dronacharya curriculum, means Arjuna is a student of Dronacharya. Dronacharya has fixed a question, asked Arjuna to face that particular fish and break it. Means teacher fixed the goal of the student. Teacher fixed the goal of the student in Dronacharya curriculum. Means he fixes it. See, your target is to face this one. This is Dronacharya curriculum. And in the next stage, that is Vishnu Sharma curriculum. Vishnu Sharma is a person who is identified to teach the students who are very innocent and ignorant. So that Vishnu Sharma started inventing what type of curriculum I should design for these students. Then who are these students? They are sons of the greatest king in those days. So that I should teach them in such a way by inventing the method of student-centric one. Students are interested to know about the stories of animals. The protagonist of the story is the animal and he has taken the animals as the real characters in the story and he started teaching the students. By that the student knowledge is elevated. These lower order level of students are raised to higher order HOT level because of this Vishnu Sharma curriculum. So those who wanted to be a good politician, they should read the stories of Vishnu Sharma short stories. Why our teachers and gurus explain this? Because Vishnu Sharma curriculum is a student centric curriculum. Okay, and here, and then Dronacharya curriculum is a teacher-centric curriculum. Teacher fixes the rule and a student has to follow it. These are the two methods of teaching approaches where a teacher has to adapt in the classroom basing on the research of the student. Simply implementing the things in the classroom is not enough. He has to observe the student and which thing is quite applicable to the students of me in the classroom. For this purpose, we should encourage the student to make accuracy. Accuracy is main important for language skills. How can we get this accuracy? By making motivation. The second one is the fluency. How students get fluent style of explaining their communication? This depends on their practice and effectiveness. Then they should explain the appropriate. This appropriateness is possible only through the strategy that they maintained in the classroom. And the intelligibility. Intelligibility of the teacher is dependent on the widespread knowledge of his understanding various books. So that the teacher is an voracious reader. Teacher should always read the things. If anything is there, generally parents say that go and ask your teacher. So that teacher is a source of knowledge. And another important skill is diplomacy. How can we get this diplomacy? Through time sets. According to time, according to situation, one has to act for this. Then what is the schema of this skill needed? What is the schema? This organization of information is called schema. Organization of information means how I collected the information and how I documented the information, how I interpreted the information, and how I came to a conclusion, and for my conclusions, what are the evidences for this is very important. This is called schema. And another important thing is schemata. What is this schemata? This is the thing where you have made a storehouse of all your knowledge. You prepared certain documents for the student. You worked very hard to prepare a questionnaire. You worked very hard to give some concept to the students. Make all of them into form of a document. And if your students are very successful, you can say that I followed this type of documentation. So my students are perfect in this. And my students got success because of this schemata I followed for this. So my dear friends, this is the way how we have to be in the classroom as a teacher and a researcher. So that, my dear friends, I would like to conclude that the profession which we have opted is a not easy one, where we have to spend a lot of time for the upcoming generation and the future of this country. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now it is open for question and answers.
Yes. If you have any questions, you can ask, sir, or you can type in the chat box. Meanwhile, I want to say my opinion.
Sir,
yes. So it was wonderful, sir. Actually, you started with teachers are sailing in two boats. One is research and one is teaching. So we have to coordinate with this.
That is what, madam, when we published certain papers in Scopus Indexed Journals at the international level.
Yes, sir.
When I published my first Scopus paper in 2012, the editor of that particular Scopus journal asked me, what is the basis of your argument in your topic which you discussed in the paper?
Yes.
Then I thought of this, so that mere saying that the understanding of the student in the classroom is very low, if you say like that, they asked me what are the reasons for that.
Yes.
And how can you came to a conclusion of that?
Yes.
So for everything, the argument of the teacher should be based on certain evidences.
Sure. Right.
So that a teacher is a researcher, a continuous researcher.
Yes. Yes. Even we don't write any research papers, we are regular researchers.
Yeah, regular researchers. Right. It is not a mere political statement or any economic statement.
Yes.
For
yes.
Even for an economic statement also, madam. The GDP of the country is very low.
Yes.
Then show me the evidences for that.
Yes.
If we show the evidences of that, yes, we can come to a conclusion. But we should not make any comment as an educated one in the society as a teacher.
Yes.
Because the verdict of the teacher has its own influence on the society.
Yes.
Even in most of the rural places, people will take guidance from the teacher.
Yes.
Even for the what we observed, even for agricultural loan also,
yes,
they never ask anyone. They directly go to the teacher and ask them that, sir,
right.
I want to take this agricultural loan of 10 lakhs.
Yes.
And they are saying that it is 10.5 interest,
right.
Whether it is appropriate or not.
Yes.
Why teacher only teaches in the classroom?
But
how can you say that the interest and the loan, all other things are, because they have a strong confidence on the teacher that they have a tremendous knowledge.
Right. Teachers can understand anything
else
of the society.
Yeah.
Right. So true. Also, you mentioned that teachers are social scientists.
Scientists.
And you mentioned one point: teachers should elaborate the idea of the curriculum designers.
Yes.
You gave an interesting example, story
yeah.
of a girl
yeah.
appeared for exams.
Yes.
That was wonderful, sir. So interesting, and we can understand that easily with that story.
Yes.
Right? And you gave so many examples of William Emerson.
Mm-hmm.
And it was a wonderful PPT with the difference between content and skill. Yes. And one more wonderful thing is you explained the teacher-centric and student-centric curriculums, giving different examples. The people know about Mahabharata, so but they don't apply to teaching. So it was different and interesting. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for sharing your ideas with us and explaining this lot and hot lower order thinking and higher order thinking, mentioning clearly and simple. Very interesting, sir. Thank you very much. And participants, if you have any doubts, you can ask now. Or you can
post questions,
yes,
in, the
post questions in the chat box. Or you can give your queries to English department so that we can post those later also. No If you are not ready to ask now, you can ask later. But I invite some opinions also, not only queries. You can give your opinion on this talk, right? Anyone? No need of accuracy and fluency, you can give.
No problem at
all. Yes. That I liked the one thing in our extension lecture that you mentioned about signing votes.
Yeah.
You have to pay fine if you speak in English, or you have to pay fine if you speak in Telugu. The result of that, students stop speaking.
Yes.
So we should not follow that. Yeah, you said the right point. I like that very much.
This is when we are discussing with the students today in the classroom also. Yes. I found this when I visited Uttar Pradesh.
Yes.
In some of the English medium schools, when I stepped into the school, there is a board that if you speak only in English, then it is okay. Speak only in English is okay.
But fine.
If you speak in other languages, you will be penalized for 200 rupees.
Let's stop them. How it is? Close their mouth.
Yeah. Right. So now we are penalizing not the student.
Yes.
We are penalizing the parents.
Yes, and we are stopping them to speak. They can't open because every student.
And moreover, in some of the schools where I observed in Andhra Pradesh, madam, they give one badge to the student who speak in a non-English language.
Yes.
They give a badge that he is a black sheep in the class.
There is
a punishment that I observed. If he speaks in Telugu or in his mother tongue, whether it is Tamil or Kannada, they give a badge to him that he is a black sheep in the class. Means every people make him inferior.
Yes.
Then immediately the inferiority complex raises in the mind of the student at the earlier level.
Yes. Yes.
So that then English is the biggest problem.
Yes.
That is the
so much impact on his personal life.
Personal life also, even on the mind.
Yes. Yes.
Psychologically, so that when I started my extension lecture in those institutions, immediately I asked them to remove those boards.
Yes, sir, you did a good job. Recently, I felt very.
Excuse me, madam.
Yes, sir. Yes, yes. Sarveshwar, sir, you want to ask a question, sir? Unmute yourself. Just I muted you. I thought someone is disturbing the class. Sarveshwar Rao sir, please unmute yourself and ask your question.
You can unmute outside.
No sir, we can't unmute. They have to. In Google Meet we don't have any restrictions.
In Zoom we can.
Yes, we can. Yeah, the control is in our hands.
Sir,
you can ask your question, sir.
Not question, madam. My opinion want to share.
Sure. Welcome, sir.
यद्यद् आचरति श्रेष्ठः तत्र देवे तरो जनः सयत् प्रमाणं कृते लोकस्तदनुवर्तते टीचर्स आर कंसीडर्ड एज द श्रेष्ठ ऑफ द सोसाइटी सो एवरीबॉडी विल लुक फॉरवर्ड टुवर्ड्स दैट श्रेष्ठ टू फॉलो द सूट सो टीचर्स शुड बी वेरी केयरफुल इन द क्लास एंड इन द सोसाइटी आल्सो एज द आर कंसीडर्ड एज द श्रेष्ठ पीपल दैट इज आइडियल पीपल that's what my opinion I want to express. Thank you, madam.
Thank you.
So
madam.
That they said that teachers are forerunners of the society.
Yes. Yes.
And Aristotle said teachers are seers. Seer means forerunners. Rishi.
Okay.
Rishi means they can visualize what happens in the future. So that Valmiki is a Rishi, where he has written the story of Rama before his birth, and he explained it to somebody else, and it came into practice. And even Aristotle also has written certain arguments, made certain arguments, keeping in the mind what happens in the future. So that Plato in his ideal state, he said that there should not be poet in the society. Poet should be thrice removed from the society, because he said that poets can make the people to be away from real life. But what happened in 20th century, people brought real life into poetry.
మేడం నాకు ఒక చిన్న సారు అంటే బాగా చెప్పారు మేడం
చేశారు
అంటే హిందీని సెకండ్ లాంగ్వేజ్ గా ఉంటే ఎలా టీచ్ చేసుకోవాలి, ఇంగ్లీష్ ని సెకండ్ లాంగ్వేజ్ గా ఉంటే ఎలా చేయాలి, అలాగే పబ్లిక్ అడ్మినిస్ట్రేషన్ అన్ని చెప్పారు, బాగుంది సార్. అంటే ఇప్పుడు మీరు అంటే మనం కాన్సెప్చువలైజింగ్ టీచింగ్ అండ్ రీసెర్చ్ అని చెప్తున్నారు, అంటే మనం గత చరిత్రను కానీ తీసుకున్నది ఇది చాట్ బాక్స్ లో చేసింది, అంటే ప్రీవియస్ హిస్టరీని కానీ తీసుకొని చూసినట్లయితే టీచర్ ఒక తన స్టూడెంట్ కి ఏం టీచ్ చేయాలి అనేది డిసైడ్ చేసుకుంది టీచర్. అంటే సమాజంలో వచ్చినటువంటి మార్పుల్ని అనుకుని ఏ టాపిక్ టీచ్ చేయాలి, అంటే మోరల్ వాల్యూసా, లేకపోతే అది తన నైపుణ్యాన్ని అభివృద్ధి చేయాలా, లేకపోతే ఉపదేశాత్మకంగా ఉండాలా అనేది ఖచ్చితంగా ఆ స్టూడెంట్ లైఫ్ కి లేకపోతే ఆ దేశానికి సమాజానికి ఉపయోగపడే విధంగా డిజైన్ చేసుకున్నాం. కానీ ఇప్పుడు వచ్చిన మార్పుల ప్రకారం అబ్జర్వ్ చేస్తే ఏం టీచర్ ఏం టీచ్ చేయాలనేది డిసైడెడ్ బై సంబడి, అంటే మేబీ అడ్మినిస్ట్రేటివ్ పర్సనాలిటీ సంథింగ్. సో ఈ పర్సన్ అంటే ఈ తేడా రావడానికి కారణం ఏంటి, ఇది ఎలా చూడాలి, ఇది మంచి పరిణామమా, ఎక్కడికి వెళ్తాం?
రామశివరావు గారు మీరు చెప్పిన దానికి నేను ఇంకొకటి యాడ్ చేస్తాను
సార్.
టీచర్ కేవలము స్టూడెంట్ ఏం చదువుకోవచ్చు అనేది మాత్రమే చెప్తున్నారు సార్. స్టూడెంట్ ఎవరిని పెళ్లి చేసుకోవాలి అన్నది కూడా టీచరే డిసైడ్ చేసిన రోజులు చూసినట్టయితే ఈతను పెళ్లి చేసుకోవాలి అని చెప్పి విశ్వామిత్రుడు డిసైడ్ చేశాడు
సార్.
చూపించిన తర్వాత వాళ్ళ తల్లిదండ్రులు కూడా ఒప్పుకున్నారు. ఒక పెద్ద రాజాది రాజు అయినటువంటి వాడు కూడా టీచర్ చెప్పింది వేదంగా
భావించారు.
సమస్య మారినప్పుడు ఇప్పుడు మనకేమవుతుంది, అలాంటి పోయినారు, అలాంటి టీచర్లు పోయినారు. కాబట్టి ఇప్పుడు ఎవరో వచ్చేస్తున్నారు, ఎన్నో రకాలుగా చెప్తున్నారు. అయితే మారుతున్న కాలానికి అనుగుణంగా ఇవన్నీ కూడా మారుతూ మరింతలోనే మన విజ్ఞత ఉంటుంది. కరికులం డిజైన్ చేసిన తర్వాత చెప్తున్నారు, ఒకటి నుంచి రెండవ తర్వాత ఇంగ్లీష్ మీడియం చూడండి కూడా చేసిన దాని మీద మనకు ఈ వాళ్ళు ప్రిస్క్రైబ్ చేసినటువంటి టెక్స్ట్ బుక్స్ ఫర్ ఇంగ్లీష్ సర్వీసెస్ పెట్టని ఉంటుంది సార్, ప్రైమరీ ఇంగ్లీష్ టెస్ట్ అని కేంబ్రిడ్జ్ వాళ్ళది ఉంటుంది, ఆ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్స్ చూపించండి. వాళ్ళు ప్రైమరీ స్కూల్ పెట్టినటువంటి ఇంగ్లీష్ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్స్ ఇంగ్లీష్ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్స్ చాలా ఎక్సలెంట్ ఉంటాయి. మా దగ్గర కేంబ్రిడ్జ్ ఇంగ్లీష్ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్ పెట్టాము, మా దగ్గర ఏ స్టేట్ సిలబస్ లో ఉన్న ఇంగ్లీష్ మీడియం చదువుతాము, అది చాలా బాగుంటుంది అని మనం చెప్తే ఎన్ని స్టేజ్ లో సమాజం ఎందుకు అట్లా మారిపోయింది సార్? మీరు కేంబ్రిడ్జ్ ఇంగ్లీష్ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్ దగ్గర పెట్టుకొని చూడండి, మన ఎస్ఈఆర్టీ వాళ్ళు చేసిన ఇంగ్లీష్ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్ దగ్గర పెట్టుకొని చూడండి. ఇట్ ఈస్ వెరీ ఈజీ అండ్ మోర్ ఓవర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎక్సలెంట్ అకార్డింగ్ టు ది సర్టెన్ లెవెల్స్ ఆఫ్ ద స్టూడెంట్స్. మీకు ఒక చిన్న ఎగ్జాంపుల్ చెప్తాను, మీరు కేంబ్రిడ్జ్ ఇంగ్లీష్ పెట్టి టెక్స్ట్ బుక్ తీసి చూడండి, అందులో ఒక సముద్రం ఒడ్డున ఒక అమ్మాయి బికినీ వేసుకొని డ్యాన్స్ చేసుకుంటూ ఒక ఫోటో ఉంటుంది. వీనికి స్పీకింగ్ స్కిల్స్లో దాని మీద ఎక్సర్సైజ్ ఉంది. స్టూడెంట్ హ్యాస్ టు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ వాట్ ద ఉమెన్ ఈజ్ డూయింగ్. వాళ్ళ కల్చర్లో అది కామన్ అయి ఉండొచ్చు. అదే మనము మన పిల్లలకి అవి నేర్పిస్తుంటే మన దగ్గర ఆ కల్చర్ లేదు, మన దగ్గర బికినీ వేసుకొని ఎవరు కూడా బయటికి రారు, కానీ మన పిల్లలకి అవి చెప్తున్నాం. పేరెంట్స్ ఏమంటున్నారు, మీరు కేంబ్రిడ్జ్ ఇంగ్లీష్ పెడుతున్నారా సార్ లేదా మీరు ఆక్స్ఫర్డ్ ఇంగ్లీష్ లెవెల్ పెడుతున్నారా అని అడుగుతున్నారు. కానీ ఇట్ ఈస్ అవర్ రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీ, ఇట్ ఈస్ ది రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీ ఆఫ్ ఎవ్రీ టీచర్ టు ఎన్లైవెన్ అండ్ టు ఎన్లైట్ ది పీపుల్ సేయింగ్ దట్ ద కమ్యూనికేషన్ స్కిల్ ఈస్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ వెదర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ కేంబ్రిడ్జ్ ఆర్ ఆక్స్ఫర్డ్ ఆర్ ఎస్ఈఆర్టీ. కంపేర్ టు ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ విత్ ది బెస్ట్ ఆఫ్ మై నాలెడ్జ్ అండ్ మై రీసెర్చ్ అవర్ ఎస్ఈఆర్టీ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్స్ ఆర్ వెరీ ఎక్సలెంట్ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్స్. ఈవెన్ టీచింగ్ అండ్ ఎవాల్యుయేషన్ ప్యాటర్న్ ఆల్సో ఐ హావ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ విత్ దట్ how the students have written answers to the questions with the best of their knowledge, not with the dictation of the teachers. It is very good, but what happened according to the changing society, the role of teacher is changed.
Thank you sir, thank you very much for your introduction. Okay, now I request Dr. Chaitanya, Assistant Professor of Botany and an active IQSC member to propose vote of thanks. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Good evening, everyone. Respected Principal Sir, Sri KSS Ratna Prasad Garu, our resource person, Dr. Gomatham Manoharacharyulu Garu, Professor of English, VFSTR University, Andhra Pradesh, Mrs. Anjali Saraswati, IQSC Coordinator and HOD of English. I am Chaitanya, Assistant Professor of Botany, and I'm happy to present vote of thanks for today's program on conceptualizing teaching and research. Firstly, we thank our resource person, Dr. Gomatham Mohanacharyulu Garu, for sparing his valuable time and sharing his experiences of teaching in post-COVID times. Thank you so much, sir, for giving a detailed view on LOT and HOT. I think the lower order thinking and higher order thinking, and also suggesting measures for implementing them. Thank you so much, sir. We thank our principal, sir, for his constant support in encouraging faculty improvement programs. Thank you so much, sir. We thank our IQSC coordinator and HOD English department, Srimati Anjani Saraswati ma'am, for the support. Our special thanks to A. Sambasirao sir, Hindi Assistant Professor of Hindi, for his technical help. I thank all the participants for being there in this program and participating actively. I think the discussion session was more good, where our resource person could give examples illustrating with illustrations. Sir has explained the queries. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, everyone, for attending this program. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Chaitanya, ma'am. And thank you, everyone.
Madam, feedback form is posted into chat box.
Yes, sir. We observed that our technical experts, I'm sure, also posted feedback form in the chat box. You can fill the feedback form and you'll get your e-certificate soon. Thank you very much. So let's call it a day.
Thank you
very much, sir.
Thank you.